Why Salvador Allende was one of the greatest icons of our history. Salvador Guillermo Allende Gossens was born on June 26, 1908, in Santiago de Chile. His political life started at an early age. In 1926, he started studying medicine at the University of Chile, where he was a student leader and an opponent of Carlos Ibáñez's dictatorship. In 1933, he was one of the founders of the Chilean Socialist Party, where he militated for all of his life. In 1939, at age 30, he started as the Minister of Health for President Pedro Aguirre Cerda and was known as the Minister of the Poor. In 1940, he married Hortensia Bussi, the Tencha, with whom he had three daughters, Carmen Paz, Beatriz, and Isabel Allende. He was deputy and senator from 1937 to 1970, and also president of the Senate from 1966 to 1969. Like his grandfather, Ramon Allende, Salvador Allende was an active member of the Chilean Freemasonry. He ran for president in four opportunities, in 1952, 1958, 1964, and was finally elected in 1970. With Unidad Popular, formed by socialists, radicals, communists, and social democrats. Allende always looked for the unity of his people. On September 4, 1970, he became the first socialist president in the world to come to power through democratic elections. In times where the way to get things changed was the armed struggle, Allende created a peaceful and democratic way, a known way, for Chile. The Chilean way to create socialism, democracy, pluralism, and freedom. The revolution tasted like empanadas and red wine. Allende had intended to end with the brutal inequalities that were afflicting Chile. During his government, with the endorsement of Congress, he nationalized the copper industry on a patriotic action, allowing that the benefits of mining stay in Chile. Applauded worldwide, Allende decided to strengthen the childhood and gave a daily liter of milk to all children from every social status. With Allende, Chile started to have international relations with all the countries of the world. In addition, he had deepened the subject of land reform, allowing Chile to have proper land exploration. His government ended suddenly on September 11, 1973. The militarists of the opposite political forces, supported by the CIA, broke the democratic tradition and, in an act of betrayal, made a coup to maintain the privileges of some people. Salvador Allende gave his word that he would respect the constitution, the laws, and the will of the majority that had brought him to La Moneda. And he did, without taking even a single step back. He gave his life to the loyalty of people. In 2008, Salvador Allende was elected the greatest Chilean in history in a vote conducted by TVN where 4 million electronic votes were cast. Allende was an example of social and political consciousness. He was tolerant and fraternal. With a sense of humor, charisma, and empathy, he had never involved himself in any corruption or scandal and always raised his voice against indecency in politics. Even in his own party. Allende was able to show a way to end with the privileges and to generate freedom, equality, and fraternity in people's lives. I have faith in Chile and its destiny, said Allende, while La Moneda was being bombed. He knew that he was talking to the history. That positive spirit of change should move us to understand that history is ours. And people make history. May Salvador Allende be present now and always.